Hello everyone. Welcome to another segment of Intellectual Brainstorming and Academic Care Excellence. My name is David Oni and my YouTube channel is David Oni Wiz. Want to use this medium to encourage you to subscribe to our channel on YouTube, which is David Oni Wiz. We also want to use this medium to say a very big thank you to our returning subscribers. And for those that have not subscribed, we want to encourage you to do the same. As you all know that this platform is for intellectual brainstorming, is to assist our numerous students out there in their academic careers and their pursuits. So today we're going to look at something different, and what we're looking at today is what is called the Richard Constitution of 1946. Previously, we studied what we call the Clifford Constitution of 1922, and we saw some of those things that that were evident under the Clifford Constitution of 1922, like a introduction of elective principle in the Nigerian electoral system, and and we also said that the Clifford Constitution actually replaced the Nigerian Council. So, in order not to waste our time, we're going to look at what we call the Richard Constitution of 1946. Now, the Richard Constitution of 1946 actually replaced the Clifford Constitution of 1922. This was because the defects or the shortcomings of the Clifford Constitution actually made the Nigerian nationalists to pressure the governor at that time from 1935 to 1943, that is Bernard Bodilon, to give Nigeria a befitting constitution. So it was based on this that Sir Bernard Bodilon divided Nigeria into three regions of North, East, and what and West, and that year was in 1939. So it was the Richard Constitution of Sir Bernard Bodilon that splitted Nigeria into three regions of the North, East, and West in 1939. So the memorandum that was issued by Sir Bernard Bodilon on the future development of Nigeria make useful proposal for the formulation of another constitution for Nigeria. So the proposal formed the basis of what of the Richard Constitution of 1946, that was named after Sir Bernard Bodilon. So the draft constitution which Governor Richard presented to the Legislative Council of Nigeria in 1946 became the new constitution that was drafted under the Nigerian constitution. And that constitution was referred to as the Richard Constitution of 1946. The constitution actually came into force on January 1, 1947. So, what are the aims and objectives of the Richard Constitution? One of them is that the constitution aimed to promote the unity of Nigeria. Then, apart from that, it also attempted to give Nigeria greater participation in their own affair. If you could remember, under the Clifford Constitution, the number, though it increased under the Clifford Constitution, but under the Richard Constitution 1946, the numbers of what of Nigeria that participated in this constitution actually increased. Then apart from that, it aimed to create a legislative council in all sections of the country where everyone would be represented, Then apart from that also, which is number four, is that it aims to create constitutional and political links between the native authorities and the Legislative Council. So then apart from that, the Richard Constitution aimed to divide the country into three administrative parts or units, which I've mentioned before, the North, East, and what are the West. Now, with these aims and objectives, the Constitution created a central legislative council for the whole Nigeria So in order to cater for the social and political difference between the different areas in the country, the constitution provided for regional assemblies in the north, east, and west, which will make new laws that will discuss for legislation. So that is it. So now let us quickly look at the Legislative Council. So the Legislative Council, like I said before this, now I said it created what? A central legislative council and what? And a central executive council. So let us look at the legislative council. The legislative council has the governor as what? As his president. And it was based in the Lagos. The council, which was enlarged, was made to allow for, all the diverse, shades and opinion and the interests of every member in the country. So it had 44 members. It had 44 members in all, made up of what? Of 28, majority non-official, and 16 what? Minority officials, which were composed of, which I will state now. Number one, the North had 9 non-official nominated members. Then the West had what? 6 non-official, nominated members. And the West, had what we call the East was represented by 5 nominated non-official members. So we have 9 plus 6, 15 plus what was 5, making 20. Then 4 non-official members were nominated to represent commercial, banking, and mining interests, as I've always said. So 4 non-official members directly elected from Lagos and Calabar. Don't forget that under the Clifford Constitution, franchise was limited to Lagos and Calabar. But now it has been expanded. And the 16 official members, 13 of whom were ex officials, and 3 nominated. So now let us quickly look at regional assembly. We said the Richard Constitution actually created or divided Nigeria into north, east, and west. So let us look at the regional assembly that was created under the Richard Constitution. So the constitution was formally divided Nigeria into 3 parts. Don't forget, divided Nigeria into 3 parts of north, east, and west. This idea was actually culminated under the Sir Bodinon, when he was governor in 1935 to 1943. Don't forget. So it was Bodinon that would have created Nigeria into 3 parts, But these were a continuation of what was done by Bodinon Constitution, which was continued by the Richard Constitution. So the constitution provided for regional assemblies. The constitution provided for bicameral or 2 chambers of House of Chiefs and the House of Assembly in the northern region, while the East and the West had one House of Assembly with only 1 chamber, chamber. So each of the chambers, each of the chambers at that time, or each of the regional assembly, constituted constituted the minority of representatives selected by the native authorities, and the minorities of officials members composed of 18 officials and 24 24 non-official members, which compose of 18 awards and 24 non-official members for the north. So 13 officials and non-official members, for the West, and the East had 13 officials and 18 non-officials members. So we're not going to discuss the function of the regional assembly, but now let us look at the achievement of the Richard Constitution. So number one is that the Richard Constitution laid the foundation for federalism in Nigeria by dividing the country into north, east, and the west. It laid the foundation for federalism in Nigeria. So another one is that the Constitution also what integrated the North and the South, you know. So number three is that by bringing this North and the South together, it laid the foundation for national unity. So Richard Constitution laid the foundation for national unity by integrating the North and the South together. It laid the foundation for national unity. Then the Constitution in Nigeria, it also widened the scope of Nigeria's representation in the Legislative Council. The representation of Nigeria in the Legislative Council was actually under the Richard Constitution. Now, let us now look at the shortcomings of this Constitution. The Constitution introduced what we call regionalism in Nigerian political system by dividing Nigeria into three parts, the North, South, and the North, the East, and the West. It laid the foundation for regional government. And you know what I mean by regional government? It laid the foundation for what we call tribalism, equitism in this country. So it laid the foundation for regional, regionalism in Nigeria, which is not good for the country. Then the Constitution is also, criticized because it made the native, authorities and the, regional assemblies selecting colleges instead of what electoral colleges. It didn't give them the privilege of being elected. They were actually selected instead of what of being elected. Then the system also introduced, we introduced what we call the system of what of indirect rule. Richard Constitution also fought because introduced what we call indirect rule, which was a continuation of what was done under the Nigerian Council by Frederick Lord Lugard, Frederick Lord Lugard. So then apart from that, the Constitution limited franchise to Lagos and then Calabar still, while other bigger towns were actually disenfranchised. And what do you mean by being disenfranchised? That is, a lot of areas were not allowed to vote, So then apart from that, by giving reserve and veto powers to the governor, it made mockery of the political system, It made mockery of the political system because it made mockery of the non-official majority of Nigerians in the Legislative Council. So this was not good for the system. Then lastly, the Constitution failed to provide a strong link between the Legislative and Executive Council of Nigeria. So though the Richard Constitution laid the foundation for regional government, it laid the foundation for federal constitution and the rest of them, but these were actually some of the effects of this Constitution, and that was why that Constitution was actually rejected by the Nigerian nationalists. And because of that, this led to what we call the Mafassin Constitution. So don't forget that after the Richard Constitution, the Mafassin Constitution actually came into force. And that Mafassin Constitution is what we're going to look at or consider in our next topic. So we have done a lot now. We have looked at the history of Nigerian political development right from the history of when the area that was referred to as Nigeria is made up of what was made up of. It was actually regarded as a mere geographical expression, which was made up of what of different tribes and languages and people with diverse cultures, languages and way of life. And these people were actually what amalgamated together in the year 1914. And apart from that, we have also looked at what we call the Nigerian Council. Then after we have done the Nigerian Council, we considered the Clifford Constitution. And then now we have looked at what we call the Richard Constitution. So on this note, we're going to stop on this topic, the Richard Constitution of 1946. Don't forget that it was actually the Nigerian nationalists that would have pressured the Sir Bernard Bodenon, who was governor of Nigeria from 1935 to 1943. To give them what a befitting their constitution. So, and because of that, Bernard Bodenon actually was treated Nigeria into the North, the West, and the East. So it laid the foundation for regionalism, and it's also what laid the foundation for what we call a federal constitution for Nigeria. But unfortunately, that constitution was also rejected, and that will lead us to what we call the Mapasing Constitution, which came into what? Into force after the Richard Constitution. So on that note, we're going to stop on this topic. I remain your humble servant, David Oni. And my YouTube channel is what is David Oni. Please, we encourage you to subscribe to this channel, because there are a lot of things that you're going to gain by subscribing to this channel. You know, we've treated a lot of topics. So apart from subscribing, also we want you to leave your comments. We want to encourage you to click on the like button and also to click on the notification button, so that anytime we upload any video on YouTube, you'll be one of the first people to be alerted or notified on this in this regard. And to the returning subscribers, we want to say a very big thank you for coming back to watch our videos. Till we meet next time, thank you so much and God bless you.